Hey, all you karate fans, welcome to another episode of Karate Corner with our always entertaining Steven Seagal. Today we're going to watch a movie called Ticker, where he is a bomb squad guy.
Did you say the B word?
You gotta be more zen. Device.
Don't use the B word.
Device. He is a device diffuser.
We treat devices.
Fine. Steven is a device treater. You know what? It really doesn't matter. This movie has been the most entertainingly bad movie in the series so far. So let's just dive into it. This is Red Eye Reviews. Now, with all of these movies, we get that sweet, sweet plot synopsis. I have never given you a chance to skip the synopsis in a Seagal series, and you know what? I never will. I'm not going to do that. We open on a SWAT team converging on the house of a U.S. senator, who is being held hostage. The bomb squad shows up, and Frank Glass, a.k.a. Steven Slowhand Seagal, finds a bomb in the basement, while this dude thinks he's doing a voiceover work for a video game.
Besides, my people want assurances the senator's okay. We're running out of time.
The SWAT team gets in a shootout and Glass disarms the bomb, but thinks it was too easy, so it must have been a decoy. And he was right, because the real bomb goes off and kills everybody while Steven just kind of walks away. A year later in San Francisco, narco cop Ray and his partner, Art Fuzzy Rice, played by Nass, and that's his name, Art Fuzzy Rice. Okay, I don't know what genius thought that up. They arrest a guy on some drug charges, and we walk in on an episode of NCIS, apparently. Yep, Seagal's bomb squad, device treater team, looks like this. Our dynamic duo is out walking and comes across a warehouse with some people in it, and I guess that's suspicious. So they go inside, and Fuzzy Rice gets shot, and he attempts to win an Oscar really, really badly.
You feel that draft?
What?
It's cold. Right? Those demons inside you?
I don't know, man. Come on. I don't know.
Nobody wanted to reshoot that scene? No? We nailed it? Okay, sure. Anyways, Ray arrests this girl. She's wearing a bracelet that turns out to be a bomb, and they just kind of remove it. Not a big deal. The boys reconvene and talk about their plans.
It's one, they're holding the downtown. And what if she talks?
She won't talk. You think he'd let one of his trusted pigment mixers just abandon him in the middle of painting a Sistine Chapel?
What the hell are you talking about?
And yeah, this was the moment I decided that regardless of how much Seagal was actually in this film, we would absolutely be watching the entire thing. I think they're supposed to be Irish? I mean, you can tell by their flawless accents, clearly.
And we'll continue our preparations.
Okay, now pull it back a bit. You're slipping into, like, Dr. Evil territory.
I'm going to place him in an easily escapable situation involving an overly elaborate and exotic death.
Oh, hey, it's Steven. Yeah, almost forgot about you. Him and his device treaters do an unboxing video that turns out to just be a doll.
All right. Yeah, I told you there wasn't nothing there.
Of course he did. Yep, you always know what's best. Ray attempts to get help from Steven and his gang.
Well, we are not going to do anything. You are going to get together with your detectives and do some detective work and see if you can find the bombers.
And I don't know what he did to hurt you, Steven, but that was really passive-aggressive. The group leader tells the police to release the girl. They decide not to do this, so he goes to a bar.
Well, hello, beautiful. Can I buy you a drink?
He apparently forgets his accent. Dude, remember you're supposed to be Irish? Even though I Googled you and you're American? And this guy's from Florida, and this guy is very English. Jesus Christ, that was in a briefcase? Did you just level a part of the city? What is this shot? Ray takes Glass to the warehouse, and they find some French cigarettes.
Gawas. Euro trash.
Which Steven identifies because
he is an expert in everything.
Yeah, and they also find matches from a jazz club, so they go to the club. Literally asking the first person they find if they know someone who smokes cigarettes. And if that isn't enough, he shows her half a smoked cigarette to really drive the point home. And she says,
"There's a guy in the club who smokes these Frenchies. It's right over there."
Thanks.
Yeah, okay, sure. Why? Of course that works. He plays it super cool, and they kill him. Ray questions the girl again. He shares a memory about his family, and she reveals the gang members' names. The bad guys go to the police station to get their bomb bracelet back. Yeah, I kid you not, that was their plan. Surprise, surprise, the plan backfires. The guys get caught, tries to kill everybody with a bomb. He gets shot. And then while the device treaters are looking around, Dr. Evil detonates another bomb. How many bombs do they have?
Thank you and call again.
You know, this guy's like if Michael Scott from The Office played a villain.
Clean up on aisle 5.
Dr. Evil arranges a bad guy gang to do a ton of bombs around the city led by Ice-T? Dude, what the hell are you even doing in this movie? We have like 20 minutes left and you show up now? And this is literally your only scene? Okay, yeah, cool, that makes sense. Well, see you around, I guess. Maybe this really is an episode of NCIS.
Medium, everything, hold the anchovies, you're the pizza guy, right?
Just all-star stuff, really. Really good performance. Ray somehow thinks if they let the girl go, the bombing will stop, so then they do that, but they give her a tracking device, and then they chase her anyways?
Captain, she's moving fast.
Dude, no, she isn't. She is wearing heels. How are you not keeping up with her? So she meets up with Dr. Evil, and they drive off together. Okay, for one, I can't even pretend you two are in the same car. And two, I don't even think you're in the same room doing this scene. I really don't. They discuss the next bombing, and the girl goes to a phone booth and detonates another car bomb. Yeah, dude, you had to have seen this coming. You guys put bombs in apparently everything you own. Just stop putting bombs in your own cars. And then through some really dumb movie logic that I really don't want to explain, they just figure out that her next target is going to be City Hall. So they rush to the building and split up to search for the bomb. And it didn't even occur to me until after this scene that Steve is a bomb guy. Why would he know martial arts? Okay, it doesn't matter. At this point, I am 100% convinced, regardless of his character, he's going to do martial arts in every single movie we watch. So they both find bombs, and Steven gives this gleaming piece of advice.
Well, which one's which?
All right, it's up to you. Pick one.
What?
It's up to you, Nettles. Just pick one.
You're all gonna die!
And that somehow works, and then Steven immediately one-ups him with his fancy bomb.
You did it, brother. Now, I got a whole shitstorm up here that I gotta deal with, so sit tight.
And he uses one of my favorite movie mistakes, which is countdown clocks that show way too little time. Like, we have 27 seconds here, and I swear to God this scene takes at least 5 minutes. But, you know, regardless, they save the day.
Love never dies. Neither do they.
And yeah, of course, you have to sneak in one more line at the end. Sure, movie's over. I told you this movie's ridiculous. I would almost believe it was intended to be this bad if it wasn't a Seagal movie. But now on to our new segment, Red Eye Reacts.
It's up to you, Les. It's all up to you.
I feel like I'm playing Metal Gear Solid right now. Look how well this fits.
Guy named Milos. Balkan terrorist. He's already killed 3 hostages, and now he's rigged a bomb in the basement.
God damn it! Don't die, Fuzzy.
Nos, did your eyes just close?
What'd you think? He's from an IRD. Very, very nasty piece of shit.
Wait, you found that in all of that? And Steven, you identified a piece of a computer chip on site? Sure.
You see, not too long ago,
dude, who are you waving at?
They're not too long ago, I...
Why do you keep turning around? Stop pointing at me. We get it.
There's only one way you can go. And that's up.
Enough talking for now.
You know, maybe this is a video game. I mean, you seriously couldn't find a way to end that conversation naturally? Are you guys ready for me to blow your mind? Steven is in the band. I kid you not. Look. That's him. That's him right there. Yeah, I double-checked the credits. He insisted on being in the band for this scene. And yeah, we all know he's also in the audience.
What's a typical profile?
If you're a dog trainer, you'd call them fear biters. They want to bite before they get bit.
How do you know that? He's like, I've been working with dogs for like 35 years.
Swan's planning a big hit now, isn't he?
I don't know.
Oh, come on. Tell me the target. Tell me the true target.
Alex Swan is planning a really big hit, isn't he?
I don't know.
Come on. Tell me the target.
Okay, am I crazy or did he literally say his lines twice? Dude, you look like if Ernest and Norm MacDonald had a baby. Okay, just watch this shot, and I swear to you that I didn't edit this.
What else? Keep going, man. You're doing a good job.
Something round.
What was that? All right, guys, that's it. Thank you so much for... wait. Do you hear that? Oh, my God. I bet my life that is Steven singing right now. Hold on. Real quick check. Yeah, I knew it. Yeah. I could tell because how good his voice is. Okay, the movie is actually over now. There is no way there's more surprises. So please subscribe if you haven't. Like the video. Leave some comments. We will see you in the next one with a movie called Half Past Dead, which I, for one, cannot wait. But until then, stay happy and stay healthy.